And I want to play the clip, what the special counsel said about the evidence that he collected, and if there had been specific evidence, he might have done something else. Listen to this.
The order appointing me special counsel authorized us to investigate actions that could obstruct the investigation. And we conducted that investigation, and we kept the office of the acting attorney general apprised of the progress of our work. And as set forth in the report, after that investigation, if we had had confidence that the president clearly did not commit a crime, we would have said so. We did not, however, make a determination as to whether the president did commit a crime.
All right, Michael Zeldin, that's a powerful statement we just heard from the special counsel.
Right. This was quintessential Mueller, a man of few words. And what he did, I think, in this 10 minutes was to deliver the executive summary that he wanted to be delivered with his report. He hit all the highlights of the testimony that's in that report in a very succinct fashion, saying the two important things that we've all talked about. One, there was an interference with the election and that the Trump administration was receptive to that. And I did not charge, not because of any reason other than the evidence didn't allow me to charge it by DOJ policy. Those are two important statements for Mueller to have made.
Which the other way to look at it is that he's saying, look, the president, you know, could have committed a crime here, maybe did commit a crime here. Because if he, by saying explicitly, if I could clear him, I would have, the flip side of that is he committed a crime. It's, and I did not have the power constitutionally to pursue it through a trial, and therefore it was unfair to make that public accusation.
And Shan, let me bring you in. Do you agree that the headline here is President Trump likely committed a crime, but I could not charge him because of the legal guidance that sitting presidents can't be charged?
Yes, I think he finally made it crystal clear that they could not charge the Trump. He felt it would be unconstitutional to do so. He was bound by that OLC regulation, and he made that crystal clear.
Office of Legal Counsel, the Justice Department.
And he said it would be unfair. He said, not an option we could consider, and since you can't take the president to court, and there'd be no proceeding while he was president, that it would be unfair to the president. But they essentially said, but here it is. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Here's 10 counts of potential obstruction for those of you who do have that option. I didn't have it.
I think that's the most important bit of daylight that we've seen now between Mueller and Barr. Until today, we hadn't really heard exactly what Mueller has to say about Barr's contention that, if you remember, Barr said that if it wasn't for the OLC, it didn't really matter. The OLC guidance did not really matter in the decision that they did not bring any charges on obstruction. What Mueller clearly said today is that is the only reason why. And so I think that is an important clarification for us to have heard today from Robert Mueller's own mouth, you know, because again, you know, his friend Bill Barr has led us to believe that Mueller told him, look, the OLC guidance didn't really matter here, that, you know, we just chose not to make a decision.
And there's also a falsehood that's been put out by the White House. There have been several, obviously, but there's also one having to do with the idea that you can't obstruct an investigation if there is no underlying crime. Obviously, many prosecutors have brought charges against individuals, including this Department of Justice in
Roger
the last
Stone,
few months.
Currently facing charges.
Yeah, even though they weren't able to get proof of an underlying crime. And it seems very clear that Mueller does not subscribe to that falsehood. He lays out the cases of obstruction, and he said if we could have cleared the president, we would have.
Exactly. What he did was repeat his findings in this report in a very succinct way. He didn't say, but for the OLC opinion, I would have charged him. But he did say, because of the OLC opinion, we didn't reach a decision. I think there's a little bit of a difference.
Well, but he also said, if we had confidence that the president did not commit a crime, we would have said so.
Exactly. And he said then,
that's the other side of the same coin.
Well, that's right. And he says, in addition to that, the process exist outside of the criminal indictment process for this to be resolved, which was exactly what he said in the report.
I think he also said we could not consider this simply because
they couldn't even consider it.
They
right.
couldn't even consider because of the OLC guidance.
Which also, by the way, might have its roots, him saying that, in the fact that there is this book by Michael Wolff that claims that they had written up charges, an indictment of the president, which the Mueller's office says is not true in any way, shape, or form. Mueller today saying, we never even could consider such a thing might have had something to do with that as well.
And I think that's an important thing for him to say publicly, simply because I think that's what the Democrats, that's the biggest thing the Democrats want to hear from him in a testimony. I think they want to hear, look, you know, could you tell us, did you draw up charges and someone told you you couldn't do it? Those are the big questions that I think people wanted to hear from him. And today he made explicitly clear that we could not even consider it because of the Office of Legal Counsel.
Because he said he accepts the longstanding Department of Justice policy that a sitting president of the United States can't be charged while in office. And as a result, they obviously did not file any formal charges against the president. And